In the last lecture, we have discussed about the open loop and closed loop control system, and we have analyzed it as in open loop control system, it is represented as the gain of power path, that is G of S, input is R of S, and output C of S. So this is the representation of open loop control system. And closed loop control system, this is represented as, we have seen the transfer function, that is GS over 1 plus G of S, H of S. This is the expression for negative feedback closed loop control system, and for positive it is negative. So in the generalized form, for the closed loop control system, it is represented as input R of S and output C of S. So here, if the closed loop control system is having the negative feedback, then the output will be, or the gain for this particular system will be G of S over 1 plus GS HS, and for the positive feedback it will be GS over 1 minus GS HS. So these are the two basic representations of open loop closed control system and closed loop control system. Today we will see how to represent the system in a block diagram, how to reduce the block diagram for analyzing the system. So we'll start with the block diagram representation. We'll start with the block diagram algebra. Any linear system can be analyzed, that is, to study the behavior of input and output of the system, we need to use the representation of that system in the form of block diagram. For example, let us consider this is a system with a gain G, where we have applied the input as X and the output as Y. This is the basic block diagram representation of a system, where we have the output as Y, input as X, and the gain of the system as G. So here, the output is Y equals to X times of G. So this is the representation of output Y, which is equals to X multiplied by G. In the block diagram representation of any system, we may have one or more than one blocks within the system, or within their particular closed loop control system. So there, we may have the summing points. And these summing points are represented as this. And always remember, for summing point, we need at least two inputs. So here, let us consider, these are the two inputs that we have at this summing point. This is X, and here the second input is Y. Let us say the symbol sign for this X is plus, and the sign of Y is negative, and the output that we are getting is Z. So here the resultant output Z will be X minus of Y. So this is the representation of the summing point where we have two inputs. As we have discussed, that it may consist of more than one block. There are some directed line segments which is used for interconnecting those two segments. These are the line segments. This can go and meet some block. It may or may not be coming from the block. It may be directed the feedback signal. So here, this is for the two inputs. Now we'll see what will happen if there are three inputs or more than three inputs. So for summing point, for the three inputs can be represented as, there is a symbol of summing point. Let us say this is A, this is B, this is C, positive, negative, positive, and the output is Y. So here the Y will be represented as A minus B plus C. Now see here, in this particular summing symbol, here we have total four semi-blocks. That means maximum we can either apply or take the signal, so that is number of 4. So here, these 3 are used for the input signals, that is A, B and C, and the output is Y. Now the question is, what will happen if we have the signal greater than 3. If the more than 3 signals are available as input, in that case, we can use this summing symbol as like this, sigma. This represents the summation, and within the circle, that is basically the summing point, and there you can connect multiple inputs. And let us say this is alpha. So this is the way of representation for the summing points. Now along with these summing points, you can have some takeoff points. Let us consider, this is a directed line which is used for joining or the interconnecting the two blocks, that is a block 1 and block 2. In between that, we can take off the signal, that is the information X, for further processing. So here, we can say that this particular point is takeoff point. So this is the representation of takeoff point. Basically, this takeoff point is used to take off the signal for further processing. This can also be represented like this. Let us say this is X. The gain of this is G1, the gain of this is G2, the gain of this block is G3. So the corresponding outputs are, this is X times of G1, this is X times of G2, this is X times of G. So this is about the takeoff points. Now let us consider there are multiple inputs and multiple outputs in the system. What will happen if we have multiple inputs and multiple outputs in the system? That system will look like this. There is a linear system where we have n number of inputs. Let us consider these are the n number of inputs and there are two outputs. Let us say these outputs are C1 and C2. And the inputs are R1, R2, and here let us say this is R. So there are n number of inputs in this particular linear system and we are getting two outputs. Now the question is how to analyze this particular system. The answer is very simple. Since this is linear system and we know that the system is actually linear if the superposition theorem holds true. So here we are going to apply the superposition theorem for analyzing of this system where we will consider one output at a time and for this output we will obtain the output corresponds to each input taken alone or separately. That means, first of all, we will obtain the result for C1 corresponds to only input R1. Then we will find out the output C1 corresponds to only input R2. And while considering either only R1 or only R2, the rest of the input will be considered as 0. So in that case, the total C1, we can have the output C1 with input R1, let us say this is C1 R1, C2 or C1 with input R2, that is represented as C1 R2 and so on. Similarly, we will have this as C1 Rn. Now we have obtained the separate output for each inputs. Now as per superposition theorem, now we will add all these outputs, obtained outputs corresponds to this input will give you the final output C1, that is the net output of this linear system, that is C1 will be the summation of all these separate output, that is C1 R1 plus C1 R2 plus and finally this is C1 R. So this is the method that we are going to use while we are having, whenever we have the input as multiple input and more than one output. Similarly, for the C2, we can obtain the result as C2R1, C2R2 plus C2Rn. So this is the method that can be used for solving the multiple inputs and multiple output operation. Now we will take one example in which we will apply all this methodology that will make us understand how to reduce the block. Let's consider the question. Find the net output for the two input system shown below. Let us consider this system. The input is R of S. This is a summing point where we have two inputs, one output with the gain of this block as G1, and this is connected to another summing point where we have one more input, that is D of S. This is with positive sign, this is positive, and the output of this summing point is directed to another block with a gain of G2, and here we are getting the output C of S, and let us say there is a feedback with a gain H. Now this is the system. Now in this case we have one output but there are two inputs. The question is to find the net output, that is C of S, for the two input system shown below. So these are the two inputs, that is R of S and D of S. Now just now we have discussed for the multiple input multiple output system we are going to use the superposition theorem. Similarly, in this system we have multiple inputs, one output, but we are going to follow the same method that we have used for multiple input multiple output operation. So in this case, let us consider in step first, let us consider R of S is used or R of X is acting alone. So if you consider that R of S is acting alone, that means we will have to maintain D of S equals to 0. That is, D of S equals to 0 is to be maintained. Now, what will happen if you make this D of S equals to 0? If D of S is considered to be 0, the signal is as it is, no signal. So this block diagram is further represented as, this remains as it is. Now here we have removed this D of S. Now we have discussed about the summing point. We have said that for summing point, what is the basic requirement? That it must have at least two inputs. Now here, after removal of this D of S, by considering this as 0, now this summing point is having only one input. So this has to be removed from the block, because summing point with only one input is having no meaning. But in this case, we will have to transfer the sign of this input signal, that is positive or negative, whatever it may be, to the nearest summing point or to the another summing point. In this case, this is positive, and we have the summing point over here. And we know that if we use the signal like this, if there is a cascading of operation, let us say there are two blocks which are in cascade, Let us say the gain is G1 and G2. The overall representation will be like this. It will be G1, G2. That means the gain is always multiplied if that is in cascading or if that is in series. So here, along with the gain, this positive or negative side, that will also be multiplied. So in this case, what is happening? This is positive. It will go like this, right? And this is this positive is going to be multiplied with the negative sign. So this remains negative. There will be no change in this particular sign. Because this positive is multiplied by negative, the sign will be again negative. Therefore, after removing this particular selling point, we have a very simple block representation that will be like this. This is the representation after removing this summing point and transferring the sixth sign to the next summing point. Now here, we will do the cascading of these two blocks, which has the gain as G1 and G2. Cascading the blocks with gain G1 and G. So after cascading, we'll have this as G1, G2. The output is C of S. This is H. This is the resultant gain for the cascading blocks with the gain of G1 and G2. Now, just see this particular structure now. This structure is nothing but the representation of negative feedback close to control system, where we have this gain as, let us say, G of S, this as H of S. Input is already there, that is R of S, output is C of S. So here we can directly use the expression that we have obtained in the earlier class, that is the transfer function for the negative feedback closed loop control system is given as C of S over R of S, that is equals to G of S over 1 plus G of S H of S. This is the basic representation of transfer function. Right? So here, we know that G of S is G1, G2. Basically, this G of S represents the forward path gain. And in this system, this is the forward path, which is going from the output of summing point till C of S. So this is forward path, and the gain of this forward path is G1, G2. So G of S will be replaced by G1, G2. Similarly, H of S will be replaced by H, and hence we will have the transfer function, that is C of S over R of S, that is equals to G1 G2 divided by 1 plus GS is having G1 G2, G1 G2, and HS is H. So this is the transfer function that we have obtained for the input R of S. Now in this case, we are taking this input as only as R of S. So I suggest instead of using this only C of S, let us mark this as CR of S. So in this case, we can have this transfer function as CR of S over R of S. Yes. The reason being that since we are applying the superposition theorem, the overall C of S will be CR of S plus CD of S. That means we are going to have two sets of output. One corresponds to the input signal R of S, and second one corresponds to the input signal D of S. So the distinction between these two and with this final output, we'll consider this as CR of S and CD of S. So we are interested in CR of S, and we have this expression that is CR of S over R of S, that is equals to G1 G2 over 1 plus G1 G2 H. So obtain this result for CR of S, that is given as it is G1 G2 divided by 1 plus G1 G2 H multiplied by R of S. So this is the first output that we need. Mark this as number 1. Now step 2. In step 2, let us consider D of S is acting alone. Now I said D of S is acting alone. That means we have to maintain this R of S equals to 0. So R of S is to be is equals to 0 is to be maintained. Now, let us make this R of S equals to 0 and we draw this block diagram again. So in this case, we'll have this block like this. Here we have the signal D of S. This is Z2. Here the output is C of S. The feedback signal with the gain H. Now again we have the same case that there is a summing point with only one input. Now again this is of no meaning. So we will have to remove this summing point by transferring this negative sign to the nearest summing point. So we will transfer this negative sign over here. Here we have a positive. So since these two are will be in the cascading, so the sign and gain both will be multiplied. So here G1 will be multiplied with H and this negative will be multiplied with this positive, so this is going to be negative. Now with removal of this summing point, it will be reduced to the form. We'll arrange it again in the basic form. Let us say this is D of S, this is positive. Here the sign is changed to negative and making it in the proper way. So D of S is the input and this symbol will be plus minus minus. That means we have transferred this negative sign of this summing point to be removed to the nearest summing point over here. So it will transfer and the cascading of two blocks. We have seen how to cascade the two blocks in the earlier one. So G1 and H, that will be cascaded. Once we remove this, what will happen? It is going to be like this. After the removal. So G1 will be multiplied with H. So that will be the representation. So here it will be G1 H. And here we have this as G2. Output is C of S. And this is the input. So this is the basic representation of the system when we have RS equals to 0 and D of S is acting alone. So D of S is the input, G2 is the forward path gain now. Now H multiplied by G1, that will be the gain for the feedback path, and the symbol is negative. That means it is going to be the negative feedback close to control system. Now this is the basic one. Now again we can say, let us say this is representing G of S and this is representing H of S, and we have input as D of S and output, since we are using the input D, so it, the output will be CD of S. Here also you can mark this as CD of S. So we can directly write the expression. We know that the transfer function will be given as CD of S over D of S equals to GS over 1 plus GSHS. So here GS is G2 over 1 plus GS is G2 and HS is G1 H. So this is the transfer function for this particular system. where we have D of S acting alone and R of S equals to 0. So here we can obtain the output CD of S that's equals to G2 over 1 plus G1 G2 H multiplied by D of S. Mark this as expression number 2. Now there is a step 3 or the step 3. Apply superposition theorem. So in this case, we are going to obtain the net output that is C of S, and C of S will be CR of S plus CD of S. So we'll add these two equations then. So here, the overall of C of S equals to G1 G2 over 1 plus G1 G2 H R of S plus G2 over 1 plus G1 G2 H multiplied by D of S. We can see that G2 over 1 plus G1 G2 H, that is common in both these expressions, G2 over 1 plus G1 G2 H. So we will take it outside. So the resultant output C of S is equals to G2 over 1 plus G1 G2 H multiplied by G1 R of S plus D of S. This is the net output for the given system with two inputs and one output. Now this was the easiest block that we have used for analyzing. Now we take another example where we have the complexity in the block diagram. We'll take one more example. Then we will see how to transfer the takeoff point. Here we have seen how to transfer the sign from one summing point to the another summing point. In the second example that we are going to take, there we will see how to transfer the takeoff point from one location to another location so that we can have the system in the form of positive feedback or the negative feedback. Closed loop control system where we can apply the standard equations or the standard expressions that we have for negative and positive feedback control system. Now let's see the question number 2. For the control system shown below, determine the closed loop transfer function that is C of S over R of S. So this is the question. For the control system shown below, determine the closed loop transfer function C of S over R of S. I will draw the block. The circuit is complex. It consists of so many blocks. I will try to draw it in the form, in the way, so that it can be accommodated on the board and we can have some more area to analyze this. So this is the system. We'll mark the sign. This is negative. This is positive. Here it is negative. That's fine. So this is the system where we have so many blocks in the gain G1, G2, G3, G4. In the feedback, we have two feedbacks. Sorry, three feedbacks. That is having the gain of H1, H2, and H3. Now see here. Just look at this. Here we have one closed loop. Here also we have one closed loop. Here also there is one closed loop. That means in this particular system, we are having total three closed loops. But we are having the problem of takeoff points. In this closed loop, there is a takeoff point. So we cannot say that this is in the form of the actual closed loop control system. When we have a system like this, this is plus minus, it depends whether it's positive feedback or negative feedback. And this is the basic representation of closed loop control system. If you compare these three blocks or three closed loop with this standard closed loop control system structure, then we will see that no one is matching. That is why we cannot apply the formula directly to this particular system. But yes, after doing some rearrangement in the takeoff points, after shifting some takeoff points or after rearranging the block positions, we will be easily in a position to apply the standard expression for the closed loop control system, either it is negative or feedback. So here, we are facing the problem of this particular takeoff point. Let us say this takeoff point is x1. So here, we are going to remove this takeoff point. If we will shift this x1 over here, if we shift this x1 over here, what is going to happen? Once the g1 is transferred, we will have the standard closed loop control system. Right? So we can write shifting of takeoff point x1 after the block with gain g4. So shifting of takeoff point x1 after the block with gain g4. Then this will be the method. What will happen if we do this? The block will be reduced to, or it will be rearranged like this. Now we have shifted over here. Now see here. The value at this, if I want to find the value over here, what is the value of that particular signal? That signal is G3 multiplied by something over here. The output, whatever we have this output over here, that multiplied by G3 will be available over here. Because the takeoff point is used to take off the signal for the further processing. So in this case, we are transferring the signal which is available over here, that is at X1, that is G3 multiplied by this symbol. So that is available here. That means it is not going to have any component of the gain G4. But as soon as we will shift this X1 over here, this G4 will also come into the picture. So at this particular point, since now shifted this X1 over here, now this becomes the X1, what is happening? Now the value available at X1 will be this hash multiplied by G3 multiplied by G4. So instead of having the value as hash multiplied by G3, now here we are going to have the value as hash G3 G4. That means we are getting one more term in this result, that is of G4. That means we need a block inside this system so that we can remove this G4. So along with H1, we can have one more block that will be cascade with H1 with a gain of 1 over G4. Now this we cannot discard. The reason being, this G4 is included in the system. So the resultant output at X1, that will be the hash multiplied by G3 multiplied by G4. But here we need it as hash G3. So we have included one more term, that is 1 over G4. So at this particular location, we have the resultant as hash G3. So there is no change in the system. Again, this particular system is representing the same. Of course, we need to draw each and every block every time. It takes the time, not an issue. But it's easy to solve, and we'll have to learn this block diagram. We'll also see the next methodology that can remove all this type of time consuming process. So, I'll remove all this. This was just for the understanding. Now, this is the case. Now, just see here. What is happening? Now, this is going to be one negative feedback closed loop control system. So, this is one system where we can apply the direct expression for the negative feedback closed loop control system. Where we have this as input, this as output, G3, G4 in the forward path gain, and H3 is the forward feedback path. Similarly, this H1 and 1 over G4, that can be used as cascade. So we'll redraw this, and the resultant will be, here we have R of S. This is G1. Here we have G2. We'll do the cascading of this, or we can try to understand what we are going to do. Cascading and eliminating negative feedback closed loop with feedback gain H3. So cascading and eliminating negative feedback closed loop with feedback gain H3. So we are talking about this, and we will also cascade this H1 and G4. So it is going to be H1 over G4. And if we eliminate this, we are going to have this result as, this is G of S, this is H of S. So we will replace this by G3, G4, that is GS, over 1 plus GS address since it is negative. So this is G3, G4, S3. So this is the overall gain after applying the transfer function expression of standard negative feedback closed loop control system. GS over 1 plus GSHS. So here G of S is G3, G4, 1 plus G3, G4 multiplied by X3. So in this block, we will write this expression, that is G3, G4 divided by 1 plus G3, G4, S3. And here, we will have the output C of S, and we are taking the feedback like this. Now we have eliminated one closed loop. Now we will try to see this. Now there are two closed loops. One is here and this is second one. Now again we are facing a problem. We cannot apply the direct standard expression for closed loop control system because of this takeoff point. Let us say this takeoff point is X2. So now once we will transfer this X2 over here, what is going to happen then? As soon as we will take off, we will shift or we will transfer the takeoff point X2 after this block. This is going to be the standard feedback control system. This is with the sign negative. Of course, this is negative sign. So this is going to be the negative feedback closed loop control system. So we will write shifting of takeoff point x2 after the block with gain g3 g4 over 1 plus g3 g4 h3. Now you know this because I need space. Now, if we shift this, the resultant will be, here we will have R of s with the positive sign, here there is a negative, we will have g1, there is another summing point with this positive sign, and here we have negative sign, this will be h1 over g4. This block is g2. This is going to be the same, that is g3 over g4 over 1 plus g3 g4 over 1 plus g3 g4 h3. Here we will have the output c of s from where we are taking the takeoff of this h1 g4, and we are shifting this feedback point, that is takeoff point x2 with again h2 towards the C of S, and we have seen earlier also while doing the takeoff, shifting the takeoff point, we will have to take care of the signal. So here the output was again the same, that is hash multiplied by G2, but as soon as we shift it over here, it will be hash multiplied by G2 multiplied by this term. So we will have to add the reciprocal of this block in cascade with the H2. So while shifting this, we will add another term in the cascade, that is the reciprocal of this, that is 1 plus g3 g4 h3 divided by g3 g4. Now this is the system that we have after the shifting of takeoff point x2 after the block with the gain g3 g4 or 1 plus g3 g4 h3. We have taken care of that signal, that it is going to give the same result, that is hash g2 h2 over here, because this is going to be cancelled out. Now, just see here. This particular block is the standard negative feedback closed loop control system. So we will apply the standard formula for this. Now in this case, we will use the cascading and eliminating the negative feedback closed loop with gain, of course with feedback gain, in this case the feedback gain is h1 over g4. So the overall resultant will be, since this is the standard one, this is the forward path, so g2 will be multiplied with this after cascading. So this is going to give you the result as g2, g3, g4 divided by 1 plus g3, g4, h3 divided by 1 plus gs, that is g2, g3, g4 divided by 1 plus g3, g4, h3 multiplied by h1 over g4. This is g of s over 1 plus gs hs. Now we have to solve all this term. So if we solve this, we have this expression as g2 g3 g4 divided by 1 plus g3 g4 h3, which is divided by, this is one term, we will multiply over here, so this is going to be 1 plus g3 g4 h3 g4, this term, plus g2, g3, g4, h1 divided by 1 plus G3, G4, H3, G4. This is multiplied over here, G4. So this term will also be G4. Yes, this will be G4 plus G3, G4, H3, G4, because G4 is multiplied over here. So this is G3, G4, H3, G4 plus this term G2, G3, G4. This H1 is also multiplied in the both in all the position, because H1 is over here. It is H1 is multiplied over here. So this is the term, and this remains 1 plus G3, G4, H3, G4. So this is G. Or we can remove this G4 straight away over here only. So in that case, it is going to give us the expression this as simply 1 plus G3 G4 H3. So this becomes 1 plus G3 G4 H3. This G4 term will not be there because we have removed it. And G2 G3 instead of G2 G3 G4 H1, this becomes G2 G3 H1. And here also, we will remove this G4, it becomes 1 plus G3 G4 H3. So this is the term that we have reduced. Now this is going to give you the resultant as, this will be cancelled out. So it will give us G2 G3 G4 divided by 1 plus G3 G4 H3 plus G2 G3 H1. So this elimination of negative feedback will give us the resultant as G2, G3, G4 over 1 plus G3, G4, H3 plus G2, G3, H1. Now this takes lots of calculations. There is another method where we can use this, where we can write this straight away, the transfer function, just by looking at the system. So here, we have this as G of S, right? So the shorter method is, the transfer function can be written as, simply, we will have to write the GS first. Then, in GS, in the denominator, of G of S, add one more term that is given by G of S multiplied by numerator of G of S multiplied by H of S. You see, G of S is G2, G3, G4 divided by 1 plus G3, G4, H3. Now, in denominator of G of S, that is this, add one more term that is given by plus one more term, that is given by numerator of G of S, that is G2, G3, G4 multiplied by H of S. H of S is H1 over G4. So this G4 will be cancelled out. So here we have the result as G2, G3, G4 divided by 1 plus G3, G4, H3 plus G2, G3, H1. Let's compare this two. This two are same. So instead of going for this long calculations, you can easily write this expression by using the method that in denominator, first write the G of S, then in denominator of G of S, simply add one more term that is given by numerator of GS multiplied by H of S. So here you will have the result. That is G2, G3, G4 over 1 plus G3, G4, H3 plus G2, G3, H1. So that is the output, or that is the overall gain for this result in negative feedback closed loop system. I hope it is clear now. So instead of using this, you can directly use this expression. Now we'll redraw this system. So this is going to give us R of S. Here we have negative, this is G1. This block we have removed. So here we have this output, that is G2, G3 G4 divided by 1 plus G3 G4 H3 plus G2 G3 H1. So now this is in cascading with G1. Here we have C of S, and these two are in cascade. So here we have H2 that is in cascading with 1 plus G3 G4 H3 divided by G3 G4. Now this is standard negative feedback closed loop control system where we have G of S as G1, G2, G3, G4 over 1 plus G3, G4, S3 plus G2, G3, G1, and the feedback path gain H of S as H2 multiplied by 1 plus G3, G4, S3 divided by G3, G4. So we can write here, we can draw this as the cascaded form. R of S with positive sign, this is given as G1, G2, G3, G4 divided by 1 plus G3, G4, H3 plus G2, G3, H1. Output is C of S. Here we have the negative feedback. The cascading H2 will be over here multiplied by 1 plus G3, G4, H3. Or we can straight away write it like this. H2 plus G2 G4 H3 H2 divided by G3 G4. Now since this is the standard negative feedback closed loop control system, we can directly use the formula. So the transfer function, that is C of S over R of S, this is given as, first we write the G of S as it is, that is G1, G2, G3, G4 divided by 1 plus G3, G4, H3 plus G2, G3, H1. Then we will add one more term over here, that is plus numerator of G of S, that is G1, G2, G3, G4 multiplied by H of S. So H of S is H2 plus G2 G4 H3 H2 divided by G3 G4. So here this G3 G4 will cancel out. So the final transfer function that we have obtained is C of S over R of S, that is equals to, we write it like this, G1, G2, G3, G4 divided by 1 plus G3, G4, H3 plus G2, G3, H1 plus G1, G2, H2 plus, okay, this H2 is again here, so we write it as G1, G2 multiplied by H2 plus G2, G4, H3, H2. Or we can take this H2 outside. So that give us G1, G2, H2 multiplied by 1 plus G2, G4, H3. So this is the overall transfer function of this particular system. So I hope you have understood how to eliminate all this block or how to reduce the block diagram for analyzing the linear system to find or to obtain the relation between input and output, or to see or to study the behavior of input and output. In the next lecture, we will see another one method, that is signal flow graph SFG, by using the Mason's gain formula, where we can have very small reduction of blocks, but we have lots of mathematical calculations. But that will be easier to solve instead of drawing all these blocks again and again, that consumes more time. So instead of doing all this reduction of blocks, we will see how to analyze the system by using the mental calculation, by using the formula of Mason's gain. Thank you.